Hello and welcome to RAF Cosford once more. Only this time we're not here to look at the marvellous aviation exhibits. We're actually here for a meeting. A meeting that is of East European cars.
Cold War exhibition at RAF Cosford in Shropshire houses a fantastic collection dedicated to a time when the two great superpowers of the NATO alliance and Warsaw Pact faced off across a borderline. That borderline, the Iron Curtain. It was chosen this year as the venue for IFA Day, which is staged by the Wartburg Trabant IFA Owners Club, a meeting that's held mainly for the owners of East German cars, though any make from the far side of the Iron Curtain was equally welcome. First of all, the Trabant or Trabi. These, the East German answer to our Mini, utilising a twin cylinder two stroke engine of about 600cc, and that give about 25 horsepower. An ultra rare sight in the West until after the wall fell. The Trabant was never actually meant for export, so stayed pretty much unchanged throughout its 34-year production run. However, a car that was meant for export and did change over the years was the Wartburg. Another two-stroke, but this time three-cylinder car. The engine said to be so simple that there was only seven moving parts contained within them, have also proved to be very hardy, and high mileages are not uncommon. Now this one was certainly eye-catching, a very early 60s Wartburg. This lovely curved and very classic shape contrasted wildly with the later Wartburgs in their bright, garish colours and chunky looks. Sadly, however, after the Iron Curtain fell, Wartburg 2 ceased production in 1991. Also using a similar three-cylinder, two-stroke, one-litre engine was this minibus made by Barkas. Also on display from East Germany, this DKW-built auto-union military vehicle. The last auto-union we'd seen was at Alton Park, and it was actually racing.
Winning. Get the side off the box.
Yeah. And the mic be on.
And back at Cosford, it's time to look at Russian cars. This Lada Riva. Ladas are still built in Russia, but are more for the home market. Here we can see an earlier Lada Riva being put through its paces on the rally course at Alton Park during last year's Gold Cup. Also from Russia, this wonderful old Volga, dating from the early mid-60s. A car that was regarded as a very high status symbol in Russia, used by party officials. That travelled all the way from Wales.
Turquoise blue, but that's got the different grille.
and it's got the stag on the bonnet.
Oh,
so
yeah.
It's a much nicer looking car.
Is it?
But we haven't brought this one to IFA before, so we didn't bring this one to stag.
That's very good.
And finally, the Czech Republic. And of course, Skoda. Once the butt of many jokes, Skodas have been around for a heck of a long time. The company started in 1895. And this fine example of a Skoda, 1920s. Of the 20 or so attendees to the show, these range from Skodas from the 60s right up to the latest Fabia. Yes, the one they do bake in the advert. And from this red ragtop Rapid to at least five Skoda Felicias, including these pickup trucks, and there were three of them. The afternoon, and of course, the heavens opened. The weather forecasters had got it right. Skoda's marketing slogan is the manufacturer of happy drivers. And I have to admit, the Skoda Owners Club certainly proved that point. A happier bunch of car enthusiasts we've yet to meet. And of course, Skodas are no strangers to motorsport. They've won many victories and been driven by top drivers, such as the late, great Colin McRae.
So there's Skoda you're driving here today. Did it bring back a few memories from the wonderful drive you had in Australia last year?
Yeah, for sure. This is obviously a 06 specification car, so it's quite interesting to drive in relation to last year's car.
Now, Hannah Nicholas designed this stage, and the improvements you would make if you were going to design it?
Yeah, move some of the trees out of the way.
Skoda owners, eh? If you can't beat them, join them. So until next time, we'll see you then. Hello again and welcome once more to RAF Cosford. Only today we're not here for the excellent aviation exhibits. As much as I like the TSR2, we'll probably be seeing it. No, Cosford.
No, that sounds a bit naff.
Okay.
Got two coming, sorry.
No, that's good. Next to the green Felicia, mate. So, hello and welcome to Cosford once more. Yeah, right next to the other one, mate. The green one, yeah.
All the way
round. Oh, hello once more, and get it right. So hello, again. Can say again, because we've got 12...
Hello!
Hello!
Hello, talking about
oh, hello! That's one of those days to do, you know, we just can't get the bugger right. Okay, lose the Scots accent. Hello and welcome once more to RAF Cosford, here in the heart of Shropshire. No, we're on the borders, aren't we? Don't keep adding things in.
No. Cut the crap, just say what you said before.
Okay. What did I say before?
Just Cosford, you didn't say.